You and your staff spend up to an hour with a prospective patient talking with them and showing them your social proof. You explain the procedure and then you go over the quote. And then what happens? Well, the majority of the time you get the dreaded, I gotta think about it. It makes you feel like you're spinning your wheels and wasting your time, doesn't it? So to help you understand the inner workings of the aesthetic patient's mind, I did research for my book, Your Aesthetic Practice, What Your Patients Are Saying About You, where I personally interviewed many cosmetic patients to figure out why they said yes to one surgeon and no to the others. Now, the majority of those interviewed were female, with the median age being 44 years old, and they were scattered throughout the US. Now, my objective was to determine trends and commonalities. So here are some of my findings. 90% of the time, the confidence in the surgeon's ability and positive staff interaction were more important than price. 75% went on multiple consultations before deciding. However, the majority of those who went on one consultation did so after a glowing recommendation from their friend or family member or colleague. Long waiting times and feeling hurried were a reoccurring complaint that hurt the relationship. And the better the staff, the less time the surgeon had to spend with the patient during the consultation. So here are the conclusions. While the above responses were interesting, it was apparent I needed to probe further to see if I could come up with some generalities that could define what made up a good practice that prospective patients said yes to. But this is what I learned instead. The aesthetic patient's preferences varied greatly. These aesthetic patients are consumers who think very differently, and their perceptions were so varied, such as, while some thought an aesthetically gorgeous office indicated pride and success, others thought it was over the top, intimidating, and it made them feel uncomfortable. Now, while some thought the surgeons did not spend enough time with them and they felt rushed, other patients thought too much time with them made them wonder why the surgeon wasn't busier. And while some thought the surgeon was so thorough explaining the various procedures available, others felt overwhelmed and confused with so many options. So I probed further and I asked, bottom line, why did they choose that particular surgeon over the others? There was a consistent answer that came up again and again. Here it is. The number one reason the aesthetic patient chose you was that the patient felt a connection with you, your staff, and the overall vibe of the practice atmosphere. It was the feeling they got when interacting with everyone at the practice. Their intuition was telling them this was the right surgeon, staff, and practice for them. They had developed rapport with people in the practice and trusted that that particular surgeon understood them and would give them the best possible result. So let's talk about rapport. If rapport is so vital, you gotta understand it. Now, it's difficult to define, and you either have it with your patient or you don't. Rapport is that bond you build with your prospective patient. It's the single most important personality skill cosmetic surgeons and staff need to be successful. Now, you build rapport through words, tone, and gestures, as well as commonalities, since only 7% of what is communicated is through your words, 38% is through your tone of voice, and then 55% is through your body language. So knowing that, how do you create rapport? Well, the aesthetic patient wants to feel special, period. When a patient is spending their own money and time on elective cosmetic enhancement, they want to be treated respectfully, professionally, and kindly by every person they encounter in the practice. They also want to be heard and understood. There's an old saying that says, before you can be understood, you must work to understand. And that is truly the case here. You build rapport by giving a cosmetic patient your undivided attention. They have to feel like you're interested in them and what they have to say. Now that starts with a smile and good eye contact. The key is to look at the patient more than at the computer or your paperwork. The point is to show interest in the prospective patient as a person first, patient second. Now, find something on the patient intake form you have in common that helps break the ice. Perhaps it's a referring patient you both know, or maybe your kids go to the same school. Another way to build rapport is to ask questions, but then listen to the answers. There's a study that says surgeons interrupt patients within 16 seconds. And that cannot happen if you're trying to connect with a cosmetic patient who's trying to determine if you are the one. Let them talk. Not only will the patient give you vital information you need to know to decipher if they're a good fit for you, the patients will feel like you understand them. That's when you have developed rapport and bonded with the patient who now sees you as the best choice. The point is to look at the consultation as a two-way dialogue rather than as a one-way presentation, so you build rapport with the prospective patient who says yes to you. If you want to learn more about what cosmetic patients want from you, for a limited time, you can get a free copy of my book called Your Aesthetic Practice, What Your Patients Are Saying, when you go to www.katherinemaley.com. Enjoy!